Hello guys, this is Funkyofile and today I will make a SF gameplay guide for you guys. I think it's a very good pick with the recent buffs, and this hero like literally can farm anyhow, like doesn't matter which race he's playing against. Like people are mostly countering SF with picking TA, but still I think if it's a good SF or if it's not a really good TA, you can still win the matchup. So we can say that this hero does not have much counters, and like recently with the recent buffs and etc, with the Venge getting buffed, Drove getting buffed and etc, this hero is just getting picked a lot more than in past, and going for right click build is a lot stronger. But you can still some games go for heals, healing dagger, BKB, and you can just blow up people. But I feel like overall it's kind of better to go for right click build. And especially if you have a Venge in your team, if you have a Drow in your team that will boost you, and etc. Boys, in this game, let's check. We don't really have much catch, which means that I should normally go for. Like, we have this catch, which is not very reliable, not a target at the table. We have Golem, and we have Interviews, and we have Pounds, which means that we don't really have a single target disabled where we can just hikes and mage and kill him. But I'm planning to get like overfed with going right click and stomping the game before this anti-mage get fed. And also Sark is kinda good against anti-mage because of the pounds, and he goes just defusal and etc, and he can just burn the mana of anti-mage, which will allow us to get a kill as well. So instead of going for a fair fire, can I have the ward as well? Instead of going for a fair fire, guys, I'm going for a mango. This will help me to sustain more on lane, and this will allow me to play more aggressive at like first lane, first couple of waves, because I will just go for this raise build. Because with going raise, guys, you can just destroy any melee hero at level 1. And if you play well enough, if you just play. If you just practice and play well enough, you can just kill your, even like not kill, but harass your enemy mid lane a lot. And as I said in my previous guide, guys, I'm just gonna place the ward after a while. It depends on the team. Like, I wanna see the enemy's mid lane overall to be able to CS better and etc, guys. So I can just place the ward either here, and this will allow me to see the rune as well. I can, if they have any, like if they have a hero that can roam, like Skywrath, I don't know, Tiny, who can kill the SF, you can always place the ward here, or to be less expected, you can place the ward somewhere here, or somewhere here even, that he would not even see if you destroy the tree. So, this game, they have SS, and I don't think that SS will be able to roam a lot, because like they have to apply pressure on Slark, because Slark is a hero that can get very strong after level 6, can just really farm, so they will want to pressure him till he till he is level 6. So I don't think I will get ganked, and besides it's a trend post 4, not even SS post 4, so I'm sure that he will stay on bot lane. Blocking is always important, boys, so always practice blocking. And as you could see, I managed to make Arteezy block, which means like one creep going from like all creeps going from left, which is a very good thing. So you can also try that, you can also practice that. My advice for you when playing SF, like try to get CS and try to harass your enemy at the same time. Or if you're, for example, like I'm playing against this shit, right, I can't really kill Invoker at level 1, or I can't really harass him. So what I'm doing, I'm trying to secure two last hits with one raise, guys. I will be just keeping. If my creeps is hitting this, like if my creeps are hitting this creep, I will try to hit the other one. So I can use just one raise to be able to secure two CS at the same time. Yeah. So try to like use raise to get CS, of course, but don't try like try to use it like for double CS or something, not just do it like for one single CS. It's not really efficient, boys. So as I said, my creeps are hitting this one. Fuck, I can see the high ground. That far. So I can pull the creep aggro, but yeah. I'm just gonna keep spamming my race a bit more, even though I'm really CSing, guys. It's really important to get secure Rage creeps, yes. So, always secure it with Raze. I wanted to get my bottle, that's why I wanted to use that Raze to secure CS, but not really. My bad. Ah, his CS, like, his hits pretty good. Invisibility. And sometimes, guys, even though you don't get the CS, you can just hit the enemy creep just to deny your enemy from getting it. So, I also advise that. And now I have my bottle, guys, which means from now on I will be free to farm. And again, creep CS at the same time, I just use my race. And like lanes is pushed for him, and I don't want to kill this CS as soon as I can, so I let it survive a bit more so I can block the wave like the lane comes to me. And when your bottle comes, guys, you can just spam your raises and etc. And I'm still doing the same thing, securing two CS with one raises. This is very efficient. And this is another trick, guys, that you can do it. Like, I think you have just seen what I have done, and if you haven't seen, just go for a replay and check what I have done, guys. This is a very good tactic on mid lane, which you can use to get CS and deny CS. So, if you haven't noticed what I have done, I have just get the creep aggro as soon as that creep was about to die, and with doing that, I didn't let, he was thinking that my, that range creep would hit my creep, but with taking aggro, it wasn't really what happened. So what I'm doing, guys, is about to be level, like, minute 4 runes, so I'm just gonna try to secure, yeah, lucky me, I got the rune. So with level 4, like minute 4 guys, minute 4 runes, I'm just pushing the lane with raises. So I can just get this rune. You can always do it. It's a very simple thing. Like, before the minute mark comes, try to push the lane. Unless you're having full control and full CS and full denies, etc. This lane, he can farm, I can farm. I care about more about getting that rune. So I'm just pushing the lane. And now, as you can see, guys, I'm almost level 6. I think he's 5.5 because of the denies that I have done. He also did some denies, but I've killed more creeps than he did. So now what I'm doing, I'm gonna just stack here if I'm on time. Not sure. I wasn't on time. Alright. Asshole. Stop me from using my clarity, and I will just go for drums. Drums does not really give good stats anymore, guys, but it's really good that it gives you a lot of high attack speed, guys, which is very good. Oops. Oh, 1 HP. And as soon as your ward finishes, guys, just get the new one because it's for free. You don't pay for it, and it's really important to have wards, especially during night time, and especially if you're playing a hero like SF. So again, it's getting to minute 6 mark, guys, so I will just try to push the lane. Oh, that race came to my home. I'm not seeing the rune. I'll just go for top rune and hope. Yeah, I'm lucky. Lucky me. And the lane is pushed, boys. So I will not bother killing that catapult and waiting for next wave to come and etc. I will just farm the camp next to my lane and go back to mid. With doing this, I did not miss a single CS, but I farmed an extra camp. This is why SF is very good, guys, and this is why SF can recover really fast. Even if you have a rough laning stage, just get level 3, get a couple of credits, or if you have your bottle, just go to the jungle. And if you're a bit lucky, you will find some runes and you will freely farm the jungle. Attacking jungle is very important, boys. So always try to max stacks. Don't forget the marks, doesn't matter which hero you're playing. Every fucking hero, for every fucking hero it's important. Max stacks. So I'm just playing a bit from behind, because if I just play from front, he will just try to use his cold snap and stop me from using my clarity. Yeah, as he is now gone, I'll just push the lane and keep farming the jungle. Oh, I mistakenly hit that creep. Okay, what I will do, I will go bottom side, because I already have two stacks, one here and one here. Since the like stacking multiple camps is a bit harder, in my opinion, just go for the stacked camps and farm them first, then go for it. Oh, it's not stacked. Oopsie. But still fine. And the thing is, guys, if I get my level 6, I can kill, level 9, I can kill this guy. I will just do it so. Let's stack this camp too. My Invis rune will pop in a second, I was going to say, and it just popped. So let's see. Let's see if he's aware of it. I'm level 9 already, and he's level 7. I don't think I will get this yet kill, but yeah. Well, at least I got a reason. Like, to be honest, he was very aware. I was not expecting him to be this aware. And to be able to kill that guy, he should be like it was an impossible kill for me, but I still tried it. It will be fine, you know, even if I didn't kill him, I will just harass him so much and I will just keep farming whole lane and even maybe treasure the store. But this guy, maybe he was just AFKing behind him and waiting for me to come, because it was too fast and I didn't even see the TP. So I think he was just sitting behind him and waiting for something. But yeah, I got a return kill. It could be better, of course, if SS wasn't there. And of course, it's better if you don't die. But it's still fine, guys. I forced a rotation. I get a return kill. Even though I don't get the XP, it's still fine. And I'm going for attack speed talent, boys. As I said, I am already going for this right click build, and I will just go for drums and manta, because they have Trent, they have Phoenix, which is very hard to play against if you don't have like a BKB or manta. And I don't just want to buy BKB straight ahead, so instead I'm just going for first item. I don't care fucking that item, because if I go there, I could just get TP'd by SS, he will just tornado and etc. I don't care about that room handle, it's not an item that I even favor at all. And as you can see. Oh fuck. You don't care about his mana. Let's go. I have 3 souls and I will just give one of these, item to one of my supports. And what I will do now, I'll just pressure the tower guys as much as I can. But he will still defend, because he's aware of it, he's not an idiot. He will just farm jungle. I have to go this way. Oh, he doesn't have mana. I'm just trying to fake Sunstrike. Alright, it was very nice that it was a free kill. It was not a free kill, but still. It's a 3-man rotation, boys. So this is why, like, if you have kind of an hero with, like, advantage, which can pressure, just do it so, boys. Don't AFK farm jungle. I could just hit this CS, like, these creeps, and boost my own farm, but with catapult, I tried to pressure the tower, and I already hit, like, maybe made it, like, a quarter HP. It was full HP, and now it's quarter. And now I can go back to farm and lose my farm. Yeah, basically this is the play that you should be doing, guys. Even if you have a bit like a lane which you're winning, like try to focus on yourself more than not letting enemy farm or something, because this hero is very strong with the farm that he, with the farming skill that he has, which is 3 rays. And I have another image rune, I can just use it to get a kill on Atmage, which is a very important kill. Because with the new fear, guys, you can get these type of kills for free with just an image rune or with Shadow Blade or something. Because you fear them, and to fear you can just 3 raise or 2 raise at least. And even if damage is not enough, you can just get the kill. Oh my god, that miss. And now, as Imokri is not throwing on mid, I'm just gonna go for the tower. Enemy's middle tower has fallen. This is something that you should be always doing with no matter what hero you're playing, boys. So if your enemy is not showing, if your enemy went to farm the jungle, boost his own farm and etc, just go for the tower, pressure the tower. Don't commit, even if you force a rotation, it's fine. I feel like they have a vision ward here. Let's see. I don't care. I'm here to talk. The play, guys, you just get 2 rays, enemy caught. Your middle tower is under attack. Take this item. I can't really speak. Yeah, so I just found an image room. I use it, boys. Attack. Don't farm the jungle because new SF can get kills. And you can also, like, when you're going for this red kit build, I have seen people going for Shadow Blades and getting many kills and kinda dominating the game. It's not good to go for Shadow Blade, as like you can always go if you need a Silver Age if you will need a Silver Age in future and etc, to go for Shadow Blade and just farm it. But in this game, we have just Ant-Mage, and I feel like if I just go right click and etc, if I just frontline, I will just destroy it. So I will not go for a Shadow Blade to get kickoffs. I will just go for Manta to be able to survive through their I don't know, their attack, guys. Let's say I don't know the word. I don't even know the word in Turkish in my own language. If they just go on me, I will survive. It is Manta. I can just call, like, I can just Manta the cold snap, just purge it. Runes are coming, I will just go for runes, they're all coming. Let's not force a fight. There's a shrine there. Try to get out. They're all coming, we're seeing them, why would we force a fight? Next to their tower, next to their shrine, because they can just buy back and join, they can just use their shrine. Even though it's not up, it's still important for us. Because we are not, like, we don't have to make a play, you know? Like, they, of course, they have Ant-Mage, but we have killed the Ant-Mage already 3 times. Which means his farm is already, like, slow, and I have super good farm. And SF is a hero that can die real quick if you're just out position, guys. So, why would I risk my life? It's being there when it's not really important. Right? Well, that makes sense. And I am going for right, it kinda depends on what you wanna go for, guys. You can also go for left, which is 30 MS, and it's very good with Yasha, with the items that we have. Doesn't matter if you're going right click, doesn't matter if you're going spell, it's always good to have plus 30 MS. But I'm just gonna go for right to be able to destroy the towers even earlier. Check the runes. Stop. Always follow the runes, guys, if you have the control of them. Like this game, I have the control, so I'm just gonna check top rune. And yeah, Arcane is a pretty good rune. DDM is a pretty good rune, and with the image I found earlier, as you saw, I just killed an Ant-Mage. So chase these runes if you have the control over them. So now, I have the Manta, guys, which will allow me to purge through Fiend Ulti, purge Cold Snap, and I will be able to confuse enemy, like to not get shackled or something. So I'm very strong right now, guys, I'm very strong, we can make some smart plays together. So I want to pressure, I want to use my our ulties like Inter Curse and etc, set up fights, and just go kill enemy. Just use smokes, guys. I you can smoke me as well. Let's play it. I'm very strong. Alright. I don't think he will die, but still, let's go. Radiant's courier has been killed. Okay, curse. As you can see, I just reheat for it the SS because I'm overfarmed, guys. Like, my net worth is 11k in 70 minutes, which is very high. Let's keep playing together. So, what item I can go? Like, I have a couple of options, guys. I can just go and get Satanic Fly and I can just be immortal, or I can go some different items, but I think I will just go for it. I'll just go for a fly. Actually, I will just go for first item Satanic, guys, because I think it's better. Because it will allow me to, as you can see, if I had my manta up, I would be able to dodge his second, but it's still fine. He will ulti, so doesn't make sense for me. Didn't run! I will die. Maybe not. Let's try. Ah, that was really close. Yeah, fucking Trent. He mistake the survived and kill me. But yeah, it's not that good. Or I can go for, like, going for Satanic is, I think it's a very strong item. Like, this is a good Satanic game because they have like many disables, and I feel like if I get Satanic, I will have like 3k HP with my powered threat strength, and I can just stay on front and I can just hit towers, hit buildings, like hit people, and I wouldn't care. I just died here because there were like two heroes on me and they had a combo, which is Trent and Phoenix. And Phoenix was level 12 actually when, like, he was here. I was not expecting him to be level 12, but it's a offlane. One, so it's normal. Let's go. I will TP bot when I have it up again because I'm very strong and I don't want enemy to get the bottom outpost for free. But, oh, okay. Select TP so I don't really need to. I can just farm the jungle. I will just keep farming, boys. Boost my farm, keep doing it. And once I have like at least like this river, I will again start playing with my. And once they have the ultis back up. Because we have some long cooldowns, I should not play in enemy's jungle because I can just feed. And if I feed right now with level 18, I will just give too much XP and gold. And it's not worth. But of course, if they make an aggressive play, I just go. Let's fight. We can fight. You can even just go rush. I will go for my river first. Later, I will get these small items. I don't really care about lifesteal because I already have from Vampire Fangs. And now, I have 2.6k HP, guys, which is like very good. And they don't even have damage. I'm just winning this game by the farm I have, guys. It's not really good. We can go high ground. Stay with me, just stay with me. I have building talent. Come, guys, come meet. Come meet, stay with me, guys. Oh, we have nothing with me. Fuck, I didn't get this. Kill the raid. Kleber zu hinten. Hit, guys, hit. Fuck, I didn't have my Manta. Oh, this is wait. Actually, what has changed with Invoker? He can use double sound strike with level 16. Yeah, that's fine. But yeah, I died because I had my Manta on cooldown and their high ground defense is a bit cancer because they have the strength shit. But we were not 5 there, we were just 3 rows there. That's why I died like without getting another return kill, but after that he just picked up the kills. But yeah, it's still fine. Even though I died, I gave my XP, but we have got 4 kills in return and we still get 3 rocks. Because at this stage, guys, I wouldn't die for free. Like, I'm super strong, and for them to be able to kill me, they have to commit. They use double sound strike, they use shackles, etc. They use Phoenix ulti, which just died right there. Just died right there. And if they commit this much, my team should be able to just be, pick up the kills. Let's go rush when we have ultis. Don't waste ultis. My courier died, fuck. Yep. Now I almost have my Satanic, guys. With this Satanic I will be a lot stronger. And after Satanic it's like, depends, guys. Like, some games you can go greedy, you can go fly or something, but I feel like if I get like an item would give me stats, I will just destroy them. Because like the normal game, you could just go for some damage items and your team should be able to protect you with this much strength and this much farm. But in case I don't feel trust my team, I will just go for one more item which will give me stats and would allow me to play a lot more aggressive than I'm doing right now. Right, guys, let's not die and go rush together. Oh, it's already farmed. But there are no camps there. Just go rush, no Phoenix ulti. Just go rush together. The game is over. Yeah, I will just get my Satanic on top and plus this Vampire Fangs, guys. And unless I get caught like 5 heroes on top of me, I should be surviving and I should be wiping the enemy. And plus I will just go for a rush, which will allow me to stay even more front, and even if I die I will get this one. This is why these timings are very important. For example, once I get this rush, okay, like the thing is, I don't care, let's go. Something. Oh my god. There's a fucking tree right there. I actually care. Let's fight them outside. It's okay, we can just kill them. I will take it. I'll just set this illusion outside. Let's go mid, stay ahead. Kill this guy too. Let's go fly. They will try to split these guys. I will just... okay. He's dead. This is very nice. Let's go mid, he's dead. For example, these guys are making mistake by going top because enemy is not threatening anything. Even if they go top, like if we just go together and bot, they will maybe take a top tier 1, which will give us a fucking fortify, which is even better for the push which is coming. But at least they got a kill in return, and I'm okay with that. Because you're super strong, guys. Let's put it up. I'll just use my Mantle from Zone because I don't care what disables they have. There's no way that they can kill. And as you can see, with his armor talent, buildings are disappearing. And a simple win, boys. Even though I died a couple of times, it doesn't really matter. We have got return kills in, like, we have got the kills in return, so it's fine. As you can see, these towers are not defense, it's very good. But yeah, if you think that this game can last longer, we can do hit towers, you can just go for MS Talon, which is very good also. Yeah. I'll just hit the tower. That's okay.
It is not magic brings me back, but purity of will.
Well, I hit first. Yeah, well played, GG. So yeah, boys, it was a very simple game. My plan was very simple, and it of course depends on the game. Some games where you should play active, where you can go for Shadow Blade. Some games where you have to go for, as I said, like there is not much right click, you can just go, like you don't have disable, so you should go for, I don't know, spell damage, which is like use dagger, etc. I think it's still viable. But I think overall this type of like this gameplay which I did, it can be valid like for 80% of the SF games, and I think you will have a big advantage with just what I have done. And as you can see, guys, look at the farm between me and Invoker, or between me or at the second hero. Like with farming jungle, with checking runes, with getting early bottle, I have just like 2k difference between me and Invoker, because I can just farm two camps, farm the lane and go back to jungle, and if Invoker tries to catch me by farming jungle, I can just hit the tower. So you have to get advantage, guys. This is what I have done. As soon as he was away from the lane, I was trying to pressure the tower with pushing lane, and as soon as he comes back, I was just getting the CS and going back to jungle, because I can die with a rotation, like SS TP'd mid and killed me with Invoker. So SF is such a hero that can get killed easily with early rotations like Tiny and etc. So I suggest you to get your own ward at minute 5-6 before even your ward expires, and just place it. And as I said, if you can pressure, go pressure. If you can't pressure, take the farm, go back to your jungle, get some clarities, chase some runes. And with the runes, if you can make play, just go make some play. If you find an invis rune, if you have ulti, go kill enemies carry in the jungle. If you have haste, go make a rotation, TP somewhere and get 2 kills in return, etc. It depends. Get Arcane Rune, go jungle, farm the jungle. Get regen, go jungle, farm the jungle. So yeah, boys, this was it for this SF guide. It was a very simple game, and I think it was overall very simple gameplay, which you can just do it by yourself, just by playing the hero and practicing it. And what I have done on laning stage at the first couple levels, I started with my race, and I told you again, I am going to tell you again, always try to get 2 CS, but it's not a must, guys. Like, just don't try to force yourself to get 2 CS with one race. Don't force for yourself for that. If you can do that, just go for it. If your creep's hitting one creep, hit another one and pull the creep wave, right? With doing that, you can just farm against even like any counter, doesn't matter. If your enemy picks TA, you can just get the CS, get clarity, get your level 3, go to jungle. So yeah, that's it for this SF guide, guys, and I hope you guys liked it. So that's it for me, and see you guys all. And if you haven't subscribed, go ahead and subscribe, guys, because I know I have been saying the same shit for a long time, but with the new year, I think I will start uploading more videos on YouTube and doing this type of guides a lot more often than I'm doing right now. So if you haven't tuned in, go ahead and tune in, and I'm sure you will find some heroes that will help you to improve your gameplay. You will find some guides that will help you improve your gameplay. And if you don't follow my Twitch channel, go follow my Twitch channel as well, guys, because I'm sometimes toxic on Twitch, but I think you can still enjoy the streams and etc. So yeah, guys, thank you all for watching, and see you guys in the next guide.